Primary 7 pupils, I am Rhona Wood. I'm the homeschooling worker at New Elgin Primary School, for those of you who don't know me. Miss Buchan, who's the deputy head teacher at Elgin High School, and myself have set up a virtual video tour of Elgin High School so you can see the rooms, the departments, and the setup of the school so that you can find yourself around when you start back after the summer holidays. Fingers crossed. I hope you enjoy the tour and I'll speak to you again later. See you soon. Enjoy. This is reception area for visitors and if you're late. And this is the main entry door for all pupils coming into school every single day. If you come in the main front door, this is the office staff. We'll be in this office to greet you, especially if you're late into school, you have any notes you want to give in or let them know of appointments that you have. If you're unwell, you'll be sent down here from your classroom for the office staff to assess how you are. Then you'll then be taken into the medical room next to the office staff. And if necessary, phone calls over to parents. Along this corridor is the janitor's room, which you should not need. And we move on to the deputy head teacher's rooms. There is one, there is two, and there is three deputy head teacher rooms and a meeting room in the middle and the head teacher room as well. These are all in the corridor linked with the school office, which is down the bottom here. Then we go into the hall. Dining room, you see the tables there, they get set out every lunchtime, break time. And this is the door you would have come in to first thing in the morning. There is a lift at the side of the hallway for people who have lift passes and need to use it to get up to the floors. Nobody else needs to use it. It's right beside the door of the stairway, which everybody else will use to get up to the top floors, beside the doors you came in, and in the hallway. In the main hall here as well are the main toilets for boys and girls. As you can see, there's the male toilets. You go in there. And the female toilets on this side. So go in there. And they are just right outside the hall. In the hall, these stairways lead up to the floors as well. And you arrive in the library. Library office. Computers. Books and tables to sit at. From here you can see down into the dining area. So from the top of the stairs, if we turn this way, you get into the English department. The rooms are numbered and colour coordinated. You can see inside the room there. And you'll have that on your timetable so you know where you're going to.
very similar. And as you can see, each floor has these maps on them. So you can see where you are, what's on this floor, and which way you need to go for the different subjects that you need to go to. Staircase, up and down, the floors. As you walk further along, this is again F49 on the yellow zone, and it's Graphcom. You can see all the computers inside. Another classroom for Graphcom with computers inside. Very similar. Staircase. And if we go along this corridor, you come to the music department, and we have a recording studio also. Two rooms here, both for music. Second music room. Walking away from the music department, we come into the corridor, and here is modern languages area. So again, numbers on the door. In the classroom, still in the yellow zone. This is the classrooms you'll come to do your languages. Social services. Again, staircase. And we are once more near the big hall. So this is your social science block, which is geography, history, modern studies. Each class has a different subject in it. Started off, but at the other side. Two more classrooms down the end of the corridor, that is for social sciences. Ladies' toilets at this side. Staircase at this side, ready to go up and see the subjects up on the next floor. Top of the stairs, a bar. To tell you which where we are and what goes on up here. Turn to left and go down. And there is Moth Department. Number on the door, classroom. We're now in the blue zone. Across from these two classrooms is the Business Education and ICT Suite. Again in the blue zone. Lots of computers. Do a turn left and head along the corridor. We'll see what else is here. The map on the wall again. Show us we are heading towards food technology. After the maths department. As you can see, we're on the top. Library is there. Atrium dining area is down here. There's a lift that people with lift passes are allowed to use. Lockers. For some pupils, that'll be explained to you later. Cell room for doing some fabric work. Next door to that, we'll make an ergonomics room. Food technology, another food technology room. Same as the one next door. As you can see here, this is the art room. Lots and lots of desks, lots of room, lots of spaces to work. Goes right over to the other side. You can make the art room and head along the corridor so you can see where it leads. That's all the way back down to the maths department. This is us going along the corridor. This is all the art room to the right hand side. It's the room I've just shown you. And we come to stair D. And this is the other side of that room. We're just coming over for the art department. Now, down this corridor. Still in the blue zone. We head towards the science department. So. Science classroom with tables in it. Another science classroom. Back at the lockers and looking across the other side of the corridor. Another science lab. Again, numbers on the doors, blue zone, in the classroom. And one next door. Different sciences, biology, chemistry and physics, but you'll learn about all of them in first year. We are back to the science lab being on this side. And across from this one is the business and ICT suite, exactly where we started off at the other side. Come right round in a square again. More lockers at this side. And once you reach S6, you get your own study area. You can see it's called Senior Study and it actually looks out over the library. You're all right in there when you're in A6. And we are right back to the corridor we started in and the staircase we originally came up on. Each staircase has the map on it to show you what this floor is, what's on it, and where you are.
Hi guys, Miss Buchan, Deputy Head at Elgin High. Just wanted to say hello. Been working with Rhona on the tour that she's been doing just now. So I'm going to take you on the rest of it down the bottom floor. We have everything on a square, like Rhona already mentioned. And we're going to go and take a wander around the enhanced provision and the support for learning departments and guidance. Places where you can go if you are needing a bit of help or if it's just to say hello, because they're all very friendly.
To give you an idea, we're starting at the door where you would come in every morning, and if I span round you should be able to tell me that we're coming into the atrium, which is where the canteen is. Alright, and we're going to go for a wee wander around the enhanced provision. So this is where any young people who need a wee bit extra help, or do you know what, it's a fairly open place, so you can come in and say hello. These are both guidance rooms, so these are rooms that you will have PSE in, like Rhona said earlier, colour coded. Bottom floor, it's a G number, ground floor number 3, and it's in the purple area. So as we go along here, it's a wee bit dark but the lights have come on. There's lots of offices for staff to be working in and for rooms for you to work with staff when you're here. And as we come through here, you'll see that we've got a garden area out the back, which a lot of young people like to hang out in lunch times and break times and get a really nice sense of an outdoor space there. And there's movement in terms of developing it even further. So if we come back round, this is the staff's locker area. But as we come along here, this is the enhanced provision area, where there's a small kitchen for small group work to be going on. And then there are classrooms along here. Once again, purple. Okay, and then we've got the enhanced provision open area, which is where there's chill and spill, Lego building, etc. on at lunchtimes. We have support for learning down this corridor, which is where all the young people who maybe need a wee bit more extra help or actually are just feeling a wee bit overwhelmed at times. There are lots of lovely staff down here who constantly work with them, and as you can see, the rooms have got lots and lots of pictures on them and they are very, very vibrant. And once again, keep turning round, keep turning right, you end up back in the atrium. And in the atrium, right in the corner, is the guidance base, G27. And in here, you would find all of your guidance teachers with our new houses. Okay, so we've got Jura, we've got Iona, we've got Skye, and we've got Arran, which are all Scottish islands that was voted on by our school community. So, just to pull it all together, that's the full map of the school. Ground floor is purple. First floor, 1F, first floor is yellow. And then the top floor, 2F, is blue. Lots of people always ask us, how do we pay for our canteen food? How do we get our lunch times? How do we get our pancakes? All these different things. The school has got a fantastic reputation for good food. So you will see that there are 4 different serveries, one in front of us. That's for lunchtime, for break time mainly, and you get muffins, etc. Over at this one is a sandwich bar, which is always open at lunchtime. Over at this one, it's open both times during the day, and there are snack bars, and then we have our hot counter, which is over here. Sorry about the rubbish, we're obviously having a clear out. Okay, so there's lots and lots of opportunity for you to have fantastic food here. This machine here allows you on a Friday, because we finish at 1:10, to get your lunch ordered. So you order it on a Friday morning at break time, and then it's ready for you to pick up before you leave at 1:10. And for those of you who know about the cashless catering, some of you have already applied for your Young Scot card, which is what you use here. You simply put your card in the slot here, and it tells you how much money you have. You then put your coins in here, and it goes on here and it tells you how much you've got, and then you press the blue button. Simple. But we will have lots of 6 years and 5th years who will buddy you on your first day, whenever that is, in our building, and we will make sure that you are okay with all of those things. Those buddies will be with you for at least 2 weeks, and they will make sure that you do not get lost and answer all your questions. When you come in on that first day, whenever that is, guys, you will come in to the assembly hall. And I'm not sure if Rhona has shown you, but behind here, that seating all comes out in like a big theatre, and we'll meet in here. And I'll be the one that'll be making sure that everything's okay. Other than that, I think the only department you maybe haven't seen is technical. So what we'll do is I'm going to stop speaking and I'm going to get Rhona to do that last wee bit. It was nice to speak to you.
So from the atrium, hot dinners will be here. Down this corridor, if you walk down this way, which is dark at the moment, but light should come on. We go into the technical area where you do woodwork. There we go. And also the drama studio. As you can see, the drama studio is here. Here. And then there's the technical department. Again, on a map, let you know where you are, where you're going. Staircase. Through the doors, and you are in technical. G45 and G47. So, if we go in this door here, you'll get to come in here and you'll get to use these machines following health and safety rules and regulations that your teacher will explain to you. Wearing goggles, aprons, and everything else, and make some fantastic stuff. There's another room at the this side too. Lots of different bits of machinery. Your teacher will explain to you how to use them safely. If you don't use them safely, you will not be allowed to use them. And you make some great things, these are. Some mirrors and boxes that pupils have made already. They're looking really good. And this is the outside area where you will gather before you go into classroom. The corridor where the deputy head teachers are. And across from their rooms is the drama studio. Now again, the lights aren't working right now, so I can't get in there. However, this is the other side, so there's a drama room at this side, drama room at the other side. Numbers are on the walls, so you can see which room it is here.
Again, back again. I hope you've enjoyed that tour around the school. I hope it's answered some of your questions, maybe settled some of your worries. You can see where the school is now and all the departments that you'll be going to and how the rooms are all set up. We'll catch you all real soon. We've got lots more stuff to do for transition. Speak to you all and hopefully see you all real soon.
Hi everyone, I hope you have enjoyed your tour of Elgin High School. We are very much looking forward to meeting you in person as soon as they say it's safe to do so, and we will make sure that we are answering all your worries. So if you've got any questions, make sure you ask your Primary 7 teacher. They'll ask us and we'll get back to you. Or indeed, we might see you in the house teams coming soon. Okay, take it easy. Bye.